Good evening, YouTube, and as you can see in front of me, my smooth cast. I swear I don't smoke, but anyway, the smooth cast has arrived from Smooth On the other day, and I wanted to make some test pieces before I went ahead and went straight to the helmets. Well, actually, camera guy suggested doing the test pieces.
Oh, man.
Yeah, go ahead and make sure we get show them how messy our apartment is. Thank you. He roommate suggested to just make a box, so just a simple box out of that cardstock to see how it affected it. But I went ahead and made an actual test piece so it can have a realistic, so we can see how it really affects the tabs and stuff on Pepperkern. This is the Ranger butt plate. Seriously, gotta be a better name for that. That can't be the technical term for that.
Go Rangers.
Rangers lead the way. And this is the bellicose unfolding of the Ranger plate from Fallout 3. So I think I covered all that so far. So we'll go ahead and get started. It's a simple one-to-one cast. I should be wearing gloves. Go ahead and push stop so I can... Okay. So, I got some gloves on. This stuff is, I've been assured several times and all the things I've read says it's completely non-toxic. Or at least relatively non-toxic. I wouldn't recommend drinking it or anything. And it's a one-to-one ratio, meaning equal parts B.
Looks like chili.
It's a little slow pouring. This should definitely cover both pieces. And one part A.
This is how you make a homemade bomb.
Durka Durka Jihad! Ew, that's a gross looking color. That's a really nasty looking color.
Looks like bourbon. And again, everything looks like alcohol.
Ask the Irishman what the liquor looks like. Or what the liquid looks like. He'll probably say liquid. Mix the two parts together. And now it looks like beer. Stir well. To protect the table, I put down a couple layers of newspaper and some trash bags down. And, I'll do this. And the reason I made two plates, butt plates, ass buckets, whatever you call them, was to see if what happens when you put stuff on the inside and stuff on the outside. So first I'll do the inside, the way everybody recommends doing it. And just swirl it around.
Spill it.
Spill it in everywhere. Through the holes. In the really crappy pep job. I've been doing it for 3 years and I still suck at it. So I guess that means it just takes lots of practice. Really hope I did enough to protect this table. It's a really cheap table, it's just I don't want to buy a whole lot of tables. Okay, that's piece number one. It's it takes, according to the package, it takes 3 minutes to set. And, let's see, 3 minutes to set and... Ah. 3 minutes to set and up to 10 minutes to completely dry. So in that regards, it completely blows away polyurethane resin. Now we'll do one outside, and holy crap, I have a lot left over. So I'm gonna go ahead and start painting it on the outside. And I really don't see how this is gonna lose any detail like I hear a lot of people saying. Somehow this brownish liquid is gonna dry off white. We'll see. It is starting to gel a little in the cup. And holy crap, look at that, it turned off white. You really don't have a lot of time to work with this stuff, do you? It's done. Son of a bitch.
That is no wasted product.
God damn it.
Okay, I just wanted to share some conclusions with of what I thought of using the smooth cast or whatever it's called. Here's what the outside piece looked like. I'm not sure how well you can see that. But, and here's the inside one. One thing I've learned that this is very hard with even just one layer. It actually broke during my testing, but it took quite a bit to break it with one layer. And so I've concluded that with enough layers, you can just skip fiberglass altogether, just use the plastic. Another thing I've learned was use it on the inside, because on the outside it's so runny, it's just going to run completely off. And the stuff where it does dry on there, it's going to dry and set exactly how it is running at that time. So that just going to make a whole bunch of sanding and cleaning up of this project that you really don't need to do. The thing is, once your 3 minutes are up, a lot of the polyurethane resin, it'll start to turn, as you're working with it, it'll slowly turn to gel, and eventually you can't work with it anymore. This stuff, it'll stay liquid for 2 minutes and 50 seconds, and at 3 minutes, it's done. That's cool. Excuse me. That's really cool. But, yeah, that's right. Anyway, one more thing I learned is a half an inch deep in each of these cups goes a long way. Although I am keeping this, this is really kind of cool. I'm pretty sure I could have done at least a single layer in either John or Tony helmets. Still a little nervous. I'm testing them out so far, and I think that wraps it up. Overall, I would recommend using the smooth cast or smooth on over polyurethane resin. It just works better, in my opinion. If you have any comments or questions, just put them in the comments below or write a message on the thread I'm going to put this in. Thank you for watching.